welcome to part two of me building my ultimate setup.
Guys, the last episode, we put the monitors on, we put the webcam on, we put like the arm up, and also while I've been gone, I've put up three wires ready for the last monitor, so that's ready to rumble. Guys, we put the keyboard and mouse there, we sorted out some cables and bits and bobs down there. Actually, we've got to improve something down there in just a second. And also, we put the PC behind that and put LEDs there, behind there, up there, and also added a strip behind there, which is wicked. So guys, just gonna have to ignore all this. This is just all my wardrobe stuff because there's gonna be a long wardrobe that's gonna go all the way down there. That's coming in the next few days. I've got to order it tonight. But anyway guys, let me just show you this sick thing. So guys, just imagine you've just walked in, yeah, and you're like, oh, this looks pretty boring. If you click number one on here, yeah, I'm gonna show you the setup while I do it. You ready? 3, 2, 1. Do that, and then it all comes on remotely. And also, I've got a backup remote stuck to the underside of the desk right there, just in case someone tries to be funny and nicks it. But guys, this episode is gonna be a little bit about like small touches that make a big difference. Like, I'm gonna be sorting out this shelf right here. I'm gonna be sorting out some new cables to go behind there. And I'm also gonna be sorting out a bit of cable management underneath there. And sorting out where I can put that damn Xbox, because I have no clue, because I don't wanna put it on my desk, because I want my desk to be swish. Guys, I guess we can start off with the shelf, get this over and done with. But I've done boxes up there, trying to make it look like okay. These are the products that I've got at the moment. It's a good stuff. There we go, that is that shelf done. Guys, I've also got this massive lens, and I just, look, my hands are massive, but just look how big that is.
That's what she said.
Now onto the desk part and the cable management. Oh my God, I've got to empty that bin. This is literally full of old wires and crud and crap, pretty much. Guys, you might remember me fitting this wire to the wall in episode 1. Now, I also added an Ethernet cable, but I haven't actually added that to the wall, like zip-tied it to the other wire, and that is because it's not black, and I want to go with the whole black and red and white colour scheme. If we look in here, I don't know if it's this one. No, that's all my tools and cable management stuff. Must be this one then. Yeah, there we go. So, got an extension lead, and this is my brand new cable. This is a Cat 6 Ethernet cable, and look, it's red and black. Whee! And also got another LED strip, which is going to go behind my wardrobe, which is going to be wicked. The first thing I got to do before I actually zip tie it all the way around is make sure the internet works. There we go guys, now I just have to cut those annoying like little threads off. What do you call them? I don't have a clue. And there we go guys, that just looks so much better already. So, the other day, I got this installed, right? Can you see the problem? Yes, look. It's not quite flush. That is because this white box here is actually broken. So I've got to get a new one of those, and then I can fasten this properly. This is like an old TP-Link power line kit, which actually works really quick, and I do get some good internet speeds. And as you can see, I've just put on, I've just wired around their Cat 6 Ethernet cable. Now basically guys, what Cat 6 Ethernet cable is faster than Cat 5e Ethernet cable, which I have just right over there. So this is like one small step to getting better internet for me, for my computer, make it so I can actually stream properly and have better quality uploads, if that makes any sense. Eventually I'll be upgrading these. I've got one here and one downstairs, and also upgrading some more Ethernet cables, and then we'll be good to go. There we go, that is that sorted. We're looking a lot cleaner already. Now guys, it's actually onto the desk. I do not know what to do with this cable management, because I didn't have to actually spend some money on it and get some proper racks. I didn't have a clue. However, I came across something, if I can find it. The adapters things there. Here, the IKEA cable management kit. Loads of YouTubers recommend this, and it's just wicked. So in here, I've actually bought some more hooks for it. So these are the hooks. So I'm thinking I might just put hooks behind there, there, and then like hook it all up. I don't know.
But in there I've got like some spare LED strips as well. And also I got some more remote plug sockets if I want to control any LEDs or anything, which is pretty cool. So guys, I don't know what to do with the Xbox One right now. Like, I do not have a clue, and this is not in focus. I apologize. For the minute, I might just put the Xbox, like, there. So it's just out of the way for the minute. Yeah, that's still in the way. In there, that'll do. Just somewhere out of the way. Because now it's time to tackle the cable management. So let's time lapse. Boom. There we go, that is looking absolutely amazing. Like, there's no cables apart from them, which are actually just cables going up to the computer, and there's no cables there apart from them, which is going to go behind the monitor anyway, so that's all good. Just to let you aware that those boxes there, when we've done the complete setup, they're not going to stay there. They're just tools to get this setup done quicker. So guys, I'm not being funny, but like, on video guys, these LEDs are like orangey, like ready, but in real life they look insane. They're like a proper red. Let's just go over a recap of what we've done this episode. That is looking absolutely amazing, apart from we've got to sort that out. We'll probably do that in the last episode. That, the cable management is just looking incredible. Like, you literally cannot see any wires at all, apart from the ones that are going into the computer. And also guys, we finished this. So guys, I'm going to call it a day right now. I'm going to continue doing this episode in a few days' time when I've received my wardrobe. And then the end of the episode will be when we actually set up the wardrobe and get rid of all these clothes and make it just look amazing. And then the final episode will be putting on the last monitor and the speakers and then just doing the final touches to the whole room. So guys, that should be pretty cool. I generally think, like, if you look at this angle, imagine one more monitor with two speakers. And mate, I'm going to change the wallpaper, so it's going to be like a panoramic one. Hopefully, anyway. So guys, I will see you in a few days' time when we finish this episode off. So guys, it's been a while, but I'm back. So guys, I have a bit of a problem. Now, you might remember me saying the last part of this part, if that makes any sense, that in this part, I'm going to be putting in my wardrobe. Now, I've got a bit of a slight problem. My wardrobe hasn't even arrived yet. Which sucks, I know, but I've still got some more things to do in this episode. So, let's get on to the first thing, which is to do the drone. So guys, you might know that I do have a drone. This one, which is in the bag down there. Now, I want to put it up on the wall just over there. So, I think what we'll do is we'll put it up on the wall, see what it looks like, and then, like, I don't know. Oh yeah, I've got one more thing to do after that, and I've got another thing to say as well. Guys, before we put the drone on the wall, there's one more thing I've got to say. Can you remember when I put that headphone thing right there onto there? And we didn't have the lens there, it didn't have the camera there. I took off that because it didn't look right. And I put up the camera. So I've now got a working camera, a broken camera, and another broken camera. They can be fixed and then like sorted out. And I've also got this lens. And if you remember last part of this episode, yeah, the first part of this episode, sorry, I didn't know where to put it. So I just put it up there. With the camera stuff. So now we've got cameras and then boxes, and it's a lot better than it did before. So guys, the drone is now done and it is looking pretty good. I haven't put the battery in it because I don't want to weigh the wall, or I don't want to weigh it down because I don't want to break the wall, if you know what I mean. But it looks good. So guys, the drone is up and it's looking pretty good. Now I want to put this onto the desk and fit it like properly right there. And you might notice that this is actually a different one. This is by Anchor, because my other one I tried to put in that laptop, and yeah, when I plugged it in it just didn't work, and I don't know what happened to it. So I bought this one, so I sent back the other one, bought this one. This one was cheaper, so I got £2 left. I got £2, yeah, I saved £2, if you know what I mean. And it should be better, so a win-win. Now guys, I actually have a USB extender here ready, so when I get this, which it came through the post, so I can literally just plug it in, so it's a lot, that saved me so much work.
Because then all I have to do is thread this down. It'll actually work. Thread this down through here. And then, underneath, they have like little sticky things. So I have to peel off. You probably won't be able to see it, but I have to peel off like the, you know, like sticker sort of Velcro things that stick these to the desk. So guys, now we have to sort of find the center before we stick down, because otherwise it's just going to be absolutely stupid and look redonkulous. So there we go, guys. Like, that is dead on center, I think. It's dead on center, look. That does not dead on. Oh dear. So guys, there we go. It's now, that is like literally center. I couldn't get it any better, really. If we go back, we zoom out. There we go. So it looks quite nice. Like, I'm on manual focus at the moment on my phone. Like, I've locked it, so I can't, it won't focus on the screen. There you go. It's gonna focus. So that, if you can actually see it, looks insane. But there's a slight problem. There is a little wire going around there. So what I might do is I might color that wire in black somehow. I don't know how to do it yet, but that is the port hub installed. I think with this setup, it's the small things that count, and it's the small things that can make a difference anyway. So if we just get a USB, plug it in, there we go, and plug it in, it would help if I put it the right way around, plug it in, and boom, we're done. Sick. So guys, if you are still watching the video, you're absolutely awesome. And if you could leave a like rating down below, that would be wicked. I mean, it takes like less than a second. And also subscribe if you're new. But let's just have a run through of what we've done this part of part two. So we haven't really done much, but we have done the drone. And also the main part of this episode was, or this part of the episode was that little hub. In real life, if I stand back a bit, I'm on my chair, that's why it's creaking. It just looks really good. And having that behind me there, it's just going to be so much easier, because I'm obviously always transferring video from my camera up there to this computer, so I can literally just grab a SD card reader adapter and just plug it straight into there, and it's USB 3, so it should be pretty quick. So that is wicked. No wires, brilliant. We may have to sort out the little white wire there, but I think we'll be okay. So guys, I'm going to end this episode right here. If you have enjoyed it, please leave a like rating down below. It would literally mean a lot. I'm gonna go for a target 50 likes. If we can get 50 likes, absolutely insane. Also subscribe if you're new, as I've just said. But yeah guys, part three is gonna be absolutely amazing. I always talk about part three, but it is gonna be just incredible. We're gonna have my wardrobe there, another monitor there, the lunar eclipse is there and there. And also, I don't know if you noticed, but I've just changed the colour to like a purple. But it will be back to red for episode 3. Because I normally keep on red, but I've only just realised I've changed to purple by accident. But yeah. So part 3 is going to be an absolute insane episode. So if you have enjoyed this episode, leave a like rating down below. And I'll catch you guys in episode 3 when we finish this thing off. See you guys.